around 1760, while he was incarcerated in an asylum, the text is a vast panorama of praise. It is unclear whether Smart really had developed signs of madness, or whether his father-in-law, John Newbery, also Smart's publisher, had him committed for some personal disagreement, possibly debt. Grievance only surfaces occasionally in the text, with most of the words demonstrating an abundantly rich imagination and an impressive knowledge of biblical history. One wonders if in today's more humane times, Smart might have been labeled a visionary rather than a madman. Smart's cosmological poetic vision was only brought to the attention of the wider public when it was released in 1939, not long before Walter Hussey commissioned its musical setting by Britten. The selection of text from the larger poem includes various biblical characters and creatures of God's creation, who sound his praise through words and actions in Geoffrey the Cat, when he wreathes his body seven times round. Alexander Datsun sings this solo to me. The first performance took place on September 21st, 1943, as part of the 50th anniversary celebrations of St. Matthew's Northampton.
Rejoice in God, O ye towers. Thank you.
liturgical uses, which both music and text were commissioned together. In this case, the idea arose in 1964 when the Dean of Christ Church, Oxford, invited two of the college's most celebrated alumni to collaborate on a new anthem. The substantial 11-minute work that resulted was first performed in Christ Church Cathedral in May 1965. The composer had earlier expressed the opinion that the text was obscure and difficult to set, but in truth, Walton frequently had similar problems with text and often found inspiration came slowly. Happily in this case, he successfully overcame the difficulties, producing a work of exceptional musical and emotional scope and variety that seems to raise its sights rather beyond the world of the church anthem and towards the cantata. Walton also does justice to what is generally thought to be a highly imaginative and resourceful poetic text. Among the highlights are the beautiful central duets, O Lord My God, sung tonight by Bear Carter, and the exuberant and thrilling final fugue, 12 as the Winds and Months. This piece also features a notably virtuosic organ part, late night.